Welcome back to another video about guided lab of module 11, streaming a dynamic content using Amazon CloudFront. Now in this lab, we are going to use two services. We will use the CloudFront distribution in order to feed a video to multiple playback version to customers like with handheld device, mobile devices, where different format are used using a service, which is the AWS Cloud Transcoder. Now, this is will basically use the cloud transcoder to create an Apple HTTP live stream HLS protocol, which can be played back in multiple different type of a browser that support HLS protocol. So the first thing we need to do in this lab is to check the preparation for the lab are correct. So we need to go to SC3, and from SC3, we should have a bucket, and that bucket is basically containing an input file. It's called Amazon SC3 sample.mv4. And the idea, we are going to use a CloudFront to cache this content in the edge location and stream it to multiple different type of devices using the CloudFront distribution. So the first thing after we visit the SC3 is to go to CloudFront. And from CloudFront, we are going to create a distribution. And if you click here, you will find that there is an origin for the distribution from Amazon SC3. So we will select that, which is the SC3 bucket access, which we meant allow public access. And then we will basically create a distribution. Now, in the next step, we want to create an Amazon Elastic Transcoder pipeline. So the transcoder here is going to be used mainly to stream the content to multiple different devices. So we are going to go to services, and from services, we want to go to the Elastic Transcoder, and then we create a pipeline. We will call the pipeline here is the input pipeline. And this is what read from this bucket, the SC3 bucket, which is the one with AWS training. And the role is going to be the Amazon Elastic Transcoder role, because we need to give the transcoder a permission to read and to write to SC3. Now, we will also have a transcoder for the bucket to save the playlist and the transcoded file. And this is going to be the same bucket with the storage class standard. And we will also select the same bucket for thumbnail with reduced redundancy. And then we create a pipeline. The next thing is to create a job. And in the job creation here, guys, we went to basically select the pipeline as our input pipeline. And all the files generated by the input pipeline, they will be generated under the prefix output. So basically inside SC3, all everything generated by this pipeline is going to appear inside a folder called output. And now the input key is going to be the input slash Amazon SC3 sample. And now for the output, we are going to select multiple outputs. So we are going to select the output details where we need to configure different type of HLS format. So we will select the first one, which is the HLS 2M. And you can find it here from the menu. Segmented duration 10, and this is basically the segment that we create in each output file. So the value between 1 and 260, which is the duration in second. So 10 second, and the output key is going to be for this kind of format, we will call it HLS20M. Now we could also now add another output, and this is will deal with the other format that we want to support it, which is HLS 1.5. And this is going to be the second format we will support, 1.5M, and the duration is going to be 10 seconds, and the output key, we will give it the output key HLS 1.5M. And then we add another output, and this time is going to be the HLS 1M. And the same duration 10, and the output HLS 1M. After we finish this, without going further, we need to create a playlist. So we need to add a playlist. And here the playlist, we are going to call it based on the lab instruction to be primary. And this playlist is going to be the link that we need to use to feed the all different format. Now in that playlist, when the output in the master playlist, we are going to have the playlist format in HLS V3. And here now in the output, because we have configured the three output, we could click here on the plus sign to add the three different outputs. So select them in the same way we create them. And then we need to create a new job. It says output slash. And now click on create a new job. Now the job is successfully created. So we want now to test the playback. Now, before you go and you try to find the URL, look below into step 32, because this is will show you how you can obtain these URLs. So the first thing we need to go back, let me open CloudFront in a new tab and select the CloudFront. And in the origins, you will find the domain name that we can use. You can use and copy this to a text editor. Now in your S3 bucket, go back to your S3 bucket in a new tab as well. You will find there is a multiple output generated by the transcoder as well. So if you go to output, there is a playlist called primary.m3u8. So basically going now further to back to my CloudFront distribution URL is going to be output slash this file. You could open this in a new private window, for example, to view the video. As you can see, successfully I managed to view and retrieve the website from the bitstream from a CloudFront, and this is pretty much what you need to do for this lab. Thank you for seeing this video, and see you in the next one.